Hi everyone, in this video we are going to discuss how to create a password protected zip file and unzip the same in Java. And for this we are going to use a library called zip4j. So you can see the dependency here. If you are using a Maven project, you can just add this dependency to your pom.xml. And if you are using a Java project, then just open Google and type zip4j download. Just type zip4j download and find javalibs.com here. Click on that. You can see the latest version on the top. So you can see the dependency Maven, Gradle also here. So just click on download here and click on this jar, which you see it has 203 KB, right? So just click on this so that the jar file gets downloaded. So in my case, I already downloaded jar file. I'm not going to download it again. I'm just going to add this jar file as dependency to my project. So I'm using IntelliJ. So how to add dependency in IntelliJ is you right click on your project, click on open module settings. You see three tabs here, sources, paths, dependencies. So click on dependencies tab. You will find a plus icon here in the below section. So just click on that and select jars or directories and find the location where you downloaded the jar file. I downloaded it into downloads. So just find the jar file and add it to your project. That's all. Click on OK. So we added the dependency zip4j to our project now. So we can use the classes and methods within the library now. And the first thing which we are going to do here is we are going to create an object of zip parameters. So zip parameters is a class. So we are going to create an object of zip parameters class. And then we'll use this object to set some properties. So first one is set encrypt files. We need to set this to true. Then we'll actually set the compression level. And for this, we'll use compression level is an enum, which has different values here, enum values from fastest to ultra. So these are the different levels of compression. So I'm just using normal here. And the final part is we need to set the encryption method. And again, we have an enum called encryption method where we have different enum values as you can see AES, zip standard variant strong, right? So I'm going to use AES algorithm for encryption method. All right, so now we have the zip parameters. Now we need to create an object for zip file. Zip file is another class. So we need to create an object of zip file. So zip file. And we need to pass two parameters. The first one is the file name. So we wanted to zip the file, right? So the zipped file should have some name. So I'm going to have that file name as compressed file.zip. And the second parameter is the password we need to set for this zip file. I'm going to provide the password as password itself. And this is the parameter which accepts character array. So I provided the string and converted that into the character array using the method called toCharArray, right? So now we have the zip file object as well, right? So now we need the file to be compressed. So what is the file we wanted to compress, right? So for that, let's create a text file. I'll name my file as afile.txt. And we can have some text here. This is the file to be zipped. Some text here in this file, right? Once we have this file created, so you can have this file anywhere in your on your machine. And then I just created within my project. So you use the object zip file. And within that zip file class has a method called add file. So we use the add file method and pass the first parameter, the file which has to be zipped, right? So I'm providing the file name here, so which is present within my project. So I didn't provide the exact path, absolute path. So I just provided it as the file as is. The file name as is, as my file is within the project, right? The second parameter is zip parameters. So whatever we have set the zip parameters, right? So that we need to pass it as a second parameter to this add file method. So we just need to add this exception to the method signature, zip exception, right? All right. So with this, we can actually, this afile.txt gets zipped and the zip file name will be compressfile.zip and the password to open this zip file will be password, right? So for our reference, let's say that file compressed and execute the program now. And we can see file got compressed and we can see a new file created here, compressfile.zip, right? So let's see that. So let's try to unzip this file. And it asks for the password, meaning the zip file which we created is password protected. So if I provide some random password here, it will say incorrect password. And if I provide correct password, then the file got unzipped, right? So we can see the file here which we created. Let's see this, how to unzip from Java. So we did this manually, right? So how to do this from Java? Let's see that now. We have the file and we wanted to actually extract its contents, the zipped file, which is password protected, right? So for this, we need the zip file object. So let's create the zip file object. Actually, you can use the same object here as we are within the same class, but if you want to actually unzip the file from a different class, so you can create another object of zip file, which I'll name it as some zip file one. So then we, again, like the first parameter will be the file you wanted to unzip, and the second parameter will be the password to unzip the file, zip file, right? Then use the zip file object dot, this time you are going to use extract file and provide the file name to extract. This is the place where we need to provide the location of the file we wanted to extract from this zip file, right? And the second parameter is destination path, where you wanted this zip file to be extracted, right? So we wanted, I just give some path here, extract. So a directory has to be created within this project with name extract, and the contents of this zip file has to be extracted within this directory, right? So let me again print something here like file extracted. So we already created the zip file, right? So you don't need to create it again. So I'm just commenting this out. We just need to extract this compressed file, right? So let's unzip this file. File extracted, and you can see a new directory here, extract, right? So in this folder, you can see the file which got actually unzipped, and we can see the contents of the file as well. So this is how we can zip a file and unzip them using zip4j in Java, right? So this is about single file. What if I wanted to actually zip more than one file, right? So what we'll do is we'll create the same zip file object first, and then here we can name our zip file as compressed files. We'll have a list of files which we wanted to zip, right? So I'll name the object as files to add, and we'll have these values as array, arrays.asList. The first file will be the same file. We'll have the same file, afile.txt, and then we'll have another file, which we'll call it as B file. Just import these files from file.io package, list from java.util package. List is an interface here. So, yes. This has to be file. All right. Now we have files to add, multiple files. In this case, we have two files. So we don't have B file, right? So let's actually create B file. Let's take the copy of the same file, A file, and rename it to B file. I'll have the text as this is duplicate of a file.txt. All right, we have the object, zip file object now. Now, how do we add it? We use the object zip file dot. Earlier we used add file for single file, right? Now we need to use add files is a method which takes the list of files to zip. So this is how we can actually zip multiple files using the method called add files. And you can see the output here now, multiple files compressed, and you can see a new file, compressed files.zip, right? So now let's unzip these files. So for that, I'm going to use this same object, zip file dot. And this time we are going to use extract all. Earlier we used extract file to extract single file, but this time we are going to use extract all to extract all the files within this zip file. And I'm going to extract it to a folder called extract all within the same project. It has to create extract all folder, and we should be able to see the contents within it. And you can see extract all folder got created, and we can see two files within it. So this is how we can actually zip multiple files and unzip them. So in this video, we discussed how to zip a file and protect it using a password, and also how to unzip the same. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching.